अस्सलामु अलैकुम, वेलकम टू लाइव विद हसन अख्तर। व्यूअर्स, आर टुडेज लेसन रिलेटेड टू क्लास 10th, यूनिट नंबर 3, नेम ऑफ द यूनिट रेशियो एंड प्रोपोर्शंस। टुडे वी वांट टू स्टार्ट एक्सरसाइज 3.3। फर्स्ट वी स्टार्ट फ्रॉम आवर डेफिनेशन, थर्ड प्रोपोर्शनल। व्हाट इज थर्ड प्रोपोर्शनल, लेट अस डिस्कस फर्स्ट। If three quantities A, B, C are related as A ratio B proportion B ratio C, then C is called the third proportion. Viewers, notice here that inside your four quantities, second place and third place, your second quantity will be repeated. That is, in the questions of third proportionals, you will be given two values. You will have to repeat second value at the second and third place, then the fourth place looking value will be your third proportional. Let's go ahead to solve the first question of the exercise. Question number one says, find a third proportional to, the first part is 6, 12. As just now told that you will be given two values, you will have to repeat second value at the second and third place, and to obtain the third proportional, we will suppose some letter that is not given in the question. For example, we suppose that let A be the third proportional, then we have 6:12 proportion 12:A. Moreover, we know the rule of principle of proportion, that is product of extremes is equal to product of means. So we have 6 multiplied by A is equal to 12 multiplied by 12. Just to remind you, first place and fourth place, these are extremes, whereas second place and third place values, these are means. Dividing both sides by 6, we have A is equal to 12 multiplied by 12 all over 6. Making simplification, after cancellation, we have A is equal to 2 multiplied by 12. Very simple, A is equal to 24. Viewers, such kind of easy question may come in objective, it may come in short questions. Part number 4. The value given, x minus y whole square, comma, x cube minus y cube. Our target is same to calculate third proportion. X and Y are given in the question, so any other letter other than these two we can suppose as the third proportional. So we let A be the third proportional, then we have X minus Y whole square ratio X cube minus Y cube proportion X cube minus Y cube ratio A. Again, utilizing the principle of proportion, product of extremes is equal to product of means. We have A multiplied by X minus Y whole square is equal to X cube minus Y cube into X cube minus Y cube. Keeping A towards the left and shifting X minus Y whole square on the right hand side, we have A is equal to X cube minus Y cube into X cube minus Y cube whole divided by X minus Y whole square. In the next step, utilizing the formulas, breaking x cube minus y cube by using the formula a minus b into a square plus ab plus b square, we have a is equal to x minus y into x square plus xy plus y square, and second one also into x minus y into x square plus xy square whole over x minus y whole square can be written as x minus y into x minus y. Making the cancellation of x minus y with the first as well as with the second, we are left with a is equal to x square plus xy plus y square whole square as the answer as my third proportional. Moving ahead to part number 5. Now values given, x plus y whole square, comma, x square minus xy minus 2y square. You must be clear that comma indicates the next value is given. So the two values we are given, again letters x and y are used in the question. Here we suppose p be the third proportional, then It can be written as x plus y whole square ratio x square minus xy minus 2y square proportion x square minus xy minus 2y square ratio p. Utilizing the same rule, product of extremes is equal to product of means. We have p multiplied by x plus y whole square is equal to x square minus xy minus 2y square into x square minus xy minus 2y square. Keeping p towards the same left hand side and shifting x plus y whole square on the right hand side, that is being divided on the other side. So we have p is equal to x square minus xy minus 2y square into x square minus xy minus 2y square whole divided by x plus y whole square. As the numerator is of the frame a into a, so it becomes x square minus xy minus 2y square whole square. Now inside the numerator values, making the factorization, we have x square minus 2xy plus xy minus 2y square, keeping the whole square same, keeping the denominator same. In the next step, by taking common from the first two from the place of numerator, we are left x into x minus 2y, and from the last two, taking y as common, we have y into x minus 2y. Now common among both is x minus 2y. So in the next step, we are left x plus y whole square into x minus 2y whole square, utilizing the top whole square. It is well obvious that x plus y whole square at the place of numerator, x plus y whole square at the place of denominator goes cancel. So I have my answer of third proportional of these given values as p is equal to x minus 2y whole square. Hope you all understand this easy kind of topic. It is important regarding exams. Thank you very much.